there once was a family who lived down under, a place where Christmas is found in the summer. Each year at this time, the Jones would come together to celebrate the true gift of God's Son. But although each heart was in the right place, the Christmas countdown was a pressurized race, and each family member had a small part to play in the Joneses forgetting the truth of the day. Here's Joey, the youngest. Let's take a peek, and we'll find her focus on the gifts that she seeks.
I want a slime making set and a kit to make cards and some new shoes for ballet and for soccer shin guards. All clothes must be branded, Nike's preferred, and I need a new iPad if you haven't already heard. And speaking of tech stuff, I'd like an Xbox One and a phone too, if it's okay with Mum. So Santa, I think that's all I need. And last month, I'm sure I did a good deed. Or at least I thought about it.
On Dasher, on Dancer, on Prancer, and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner, and Blitzen.
You better watch out, you better not cry, better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list and checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows if you're sleeping, he knows if you're awake, he knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out, you better not cry, better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming, Santa Claus is coming, Santa Claus is coming.
Say it. Claus reindeer. You got on in history.
But as Joey made her way through her list, she felt that something might be amiss. She couldn't quite place it, but of this she was sure. The spirit of Christmas, the joy, should be more. So she wandered downstairs in search of someone who could help her. The answer was Mum. Or so Joey thought, but at this very hour, Mum was frantic, frazzled, and covered in flour.
A teaspoon of cinnamon, a pinch of salt. If Christmas is ruined, it won't be my fault. What's the matter, Joey? What is it you're after? Is it not something that can wait for your father?
I need to know what else I can do. I need to make sure Santa's gonna come through. Do you have any more tinsel? Could we please put up some more lights? What time do I need to go to bed tonight? Should we leave Santa cookies? Or coconut rye?
But Mum just exploded.
Joey, enough. Can you not see that I'm busy? Can you go and ask someone else? Go and bother that ridiculous elf on the shelf.
She did not mean to shout. She was not always this way. There was just so much stress around the big day. Her to-do list was long, and it made her feel vexed that Dad was ignoring her SOS text. "When are you home?" in all caps it said. But so far the response had only been red. She looked at her girl, saw her downcast eyes.
"We just need a bit more Christmas,"
Joey replied.
The holly, put up a tree before my spirit falls again. Fill up the stocking, I may be rushing things, but deck the halls again now. For we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Candles in the window, carols at the spinning. Yes, we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Snowed a single flurry, but Santa dear, we're in a hurry. So climb down the chimney, turn on the brightest string of lights I've ever seen. Slice up the fruitcake, it's time we hung some tinsel on that evergreen bough. For I've grown a little leaner, grown a little colder, grown a little sadder, and grown a little older. I need a little Christmas now.
For we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Candles in the window, carols at the spinning. Yes, we need a little Christmas right this very minute. It hasn't snowed a single flurry, but Santa dear, we're in a hurry. So
climb down the chimney, the brightest string of lights I've ever seen. Slice up the fruitcake, it's time we hung some tinsel on that evergreen bough. For I've grown a little leaner, grown a little colder, grown a little sadder, and grown a little older. And I need a little angel sitting on my shoulder. I need a little Christmas.
king to see. Pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. How finest gifts we bring. Pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. A chew lay before the king. Pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. Ra-pa-pum-pum. Ra-pa-pum-pum. Pum-pum. When we come, little baby, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. And I am a poor boy too, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum.
Mum wiped her hands and knelt down to Joey.
Hun, look at Mummy. I really am sorry. I forgot that tomorrow is not about the food, or the presents or Santa, or the things still to do. All that stuff is all fine and fun, but not if we forget about the gift of God's Son. His peace and joy is all that we need.
And she leaned in close and kissed her cheek. Mum meant well, and it was all good and true, but Joey knew on her mind was all her to-dos. And she noticed that out the window an enormous bright star had begun to glow.
Is that Santa, Mum? What else could it be?
And she ran to get her brother to see.
See what I say, said the night went to the
In search of Skip, Joey remembered Christmases past, when they plotted and schemed to catch Santa off guard, with bells and tripwires, cookies left as the lure, but her partner in crime was now much more mature. Joey ran into Skip to see if he knew what the bright light was.
I don't have a clue. Sis, I couldn't care less. Just get out of my way. I've got to finish his mission today.
What are you playing? Can I play too?
Skip rolled his eyes, and at that Joey knew that she was not welcome. Skip did not want to play. He said,
No, Joey, no. Just go away. Babies who are waiting for Santa should be tucked into bed, because if Santa could see how annoying you're being, I know you will get not one single thing tomorrow, I bet.
You're lying,
said Joey.
No, I'm not,
answered Skip.
Your presents are vanishing every time the clock ticks.
Joey turned on her heels.
I'm not going to bed. I'm just getting away from the Grinch,
she said. She stomped into her room and slammed the door. This wasn't like Joey. She'd not done that before. She yelled,
You're all just dumb, okay? This is not any fun. I'm just trying to make sure Santa will come.
At that moment, Dad enters through the front door, hears the commotion, drops his bag to the floor. He marches straight up the stairs.
Josephine Jones, I will not accept all these moans and groans. Now you stop with the nonsense and creating a fuss. Have you forgotten tomorrow's Christmas?
Of course I know that.
Joey snapped back to Dad.
I've been trying all day to be merry and glad, but no one is listening to me.
Joey cried, and Dad finally noticed the tears in her eyes. He paused. Then he said,
Well, talk to me now, and we'll see if we can fix it somehow.
I thought Christmas was supposed to be special, but there's just too much to do. Mum was too busy, and you were gone too. And I tried to ask it, but he just didn't care. About Christmas at all, it just isn't fair. Santa probably won't even come this year. Because you can see, we don't have any Christmas cheer.
Dad smiled as Joey flopped her head.
Now it's your turn to listen,
he kindly said.
I know you're excited about gifts under the tree. Can I tell you what Christmas is about to me? It's about a baby born and gifts brought from afar. It's about angels and shepherds and a giant bright star.
Joey lay back on her pillows, and there she saw out the window the same star she'd seen before. She said to her dad,
A star like that one?
He smiled.
Let me tell you about when God gave his son.
Help me be strong. Help me be breath of heaven, breath of
On that day in a stable lay a baby so meek, under a star in the sky that the wise might seek. God of heaven on earth, full of wonder and awe, trading heavenly robes for a throne made of straw. Nearby in a field there appeared a great sight. Great winged creatures gave some shepherds a fright. "Do not be afraid," they sang with sweet joy, "for born is the Savior, Messiah, wee boy."
See? Invite you all to stand to your feet. We're going to worship together tonight.
Thrill of hope, the way we were. Singers tonight. Thank you so much. You can be seated. If I could just take 10 minutes of your time before we just sing one more song after this, and do really want to thank everyone for being here tonight and sharing your Christmas season with us. It's a tremendous joy for us as a church to host you here. Really want to thank the team that have pulled this off all day and the numerous weeks that led up to this. Aaron, our worship pastor, and Jake on all the video, Levi on all the sound, and all the singers and all the musicians and everyone else, everyone outside there. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Tonight, I just want to share a verse and look at one word in this verse that really gives us the whole idea of what Christmas is about. It's written in the book of Isaiah, chapter 7. And Isaiah was written several hundred years before Jesus was ever born. And it says this in verse 14. All right then, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She'll give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. This word with, it doesn't say God will be above you. It just doesn't say God's around you. It says that God wants to be with you. And in a world right now that is desperately needing connection, in a world right now that's desperately needing relationship, this word is actually incredibly powerful for you and I this Christmas. The reason why it's so powerful is basically ever since we were infants, ever since we were small, we have known and we've discovered that being alive means being alone at times. There's an epidemic around the world of loneliness. Do you realize right now in the UK that they have added a new cabinet position, and the position is called the Minister of Loneliness? And their whole job is to try and get people connected. There is a treatment in the world of psychology called pet therapy. And through numerous studies have shown that the presence of an animal and an animal companion can lessen the pain of isolation and loneliness. Latest studies show that the average person today has 50% less friends in whom they can confide in. 3 out of 4 people claim that they are alone. And then many years ago, there was the great philosopher Forrest Gump in that wonderful movie. when, if you've seen the movie, and I'm sure all of you have, when Forrest, as a little boy, goes to his first day at school and he has got his metal braces on and he's got to hop onto the bus. And every seat that he goes to that's spare, the little boy who's sitting in it shuffles across and goes, "Can't sit here." And goes to the next one, "Can't sit here." And Forrest goes to every seat and they won't make room for him until there's a little voice of a young girl called Jenny. And she says, "You can sit here." And from that, that's my best Southern accent, I'm sorry. It's as good as it gets. And from that moment on, Forrest is no longer alone. He is with Jenny. Some of the thinkers over our year that claim to be have such great insight into the world, people like Jean-Paul Sartre said this, "The reason we are lonely is we are meaning-seeking creatures but live in a meaningless world." Richard Dawkins said this, "The universe offers no design, no purpose, or no hope, just blind, pitiless indifference." Wouldn't you love to have Christmas Day with him? But the truth is that for maybe some of us today in this Christmas season, you've been through, 2019 was a tough year. And maybe there's been loss, and maybe there's been the breakup or a breakdown. Maybe there's been financial loss or some sort of ruin in your life. And this sense of loneliness is real to you. But this is the power of the Christmas story, because Christmas tells us that God never meant it this way. That he didn't want you to be a person that feels like you're existing in a meaningless life, in a meaningless universe. You were made by God, for God. In actual fact, and early in the Bible, in the book of Genesis, God actually says it's not good for a man to live alone. So God doesn't want any of us to be the kid eating their lunch at school by themselves. He wants everyone to be connected. W.T. Ellis, a 19th century politician, said this, "It is Christmas in the heart that puts Christmas in the air." And all through the Bible, God displays this desire that he has to be with humanity, to be with you and I. In actual fact, in the Old Testament, it mentions 114 times how much God wants to be with us. He wants to be with us in our fiery trials. He wants to be with us when we fear. He wants to be with us when we're alone. He wants to guide us. He wants to be with us in our worship. God wants to be with us. And the beauty of Christmas is this, is that just wanting to be with us didn't satisfy God. And so one day he thought to himself, "I don't want to just from a distance be with them. I want to go down to earth and be with these people." And that's Jesus. And that's the story of Christmas. That the biggest miracle in God became the smallest miracle in Jesus in a baby. And that in this little child, this little fragile human being that was born onto the face of this earth, God himself brought all of his majesty, his presence, his person, his power, and compacted it into this little baby. And Jesus started his journey of being with people. Started it with his impoverished parents, Mary and Joseph. And then from then on, he grew into a 12 disciples, the dirty dozen, a band of tax collectors and fishermen. And this word "with" really became, because Jesus is Emmanuel, God with us, it became his signature all through his life, that he wanted to be with people. So much impressed people in the book of Acts chapter 4, it said when people looked at the disciples, they said, "Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were uneducated common men, they were astonished and they recognized that they had been with Jesus." So all through the Bible, Jesus was with lepers, he was with tax collectors, he was with foreigners, he was with enemy soldiers, he was with prostitutes. At one time, they actually labeled Jesus the friend of sinners. It was meant to be an insult, but again, it became a badge of honor because Jesus wanted to be with people. He is Emmanuel, God with us. Right at the end of after Jesus had been crucified and resurrected, at the end of the book of Matthew, he said to you and I, he said, "And behold, I am with you always to the end of the age." And then lastly, in the book of Hebrews, he promises this, "For hasn't he promised you, I'll never leave you alone, never. And I will not loosen my grip on your life." You know, tonight, I don't know what life is like for you when you leave this auditorium. I don't know whether you go back and this Christmas is a Christmas of great loneliness. Maybe you've got a lot of family coming. Maybe your family have traveled a long distance from Cooma or somewhere like that and they're going to spend Christmas with you. But all of us at some point in our life recognize that there is a hole in our heart that we try and fill in numerous ways. We try and fill it with substance and alcohol or maybe drugs. We try and fill it with relationships. We try and fill it with multiple marriages. We try and fill it with success. And hopefully the more money I get in my account, the happier I'll be. And yet, why is it still at night? Why is it sometimes when you find yourself in the middle of the day or walking on a beach, there's this ache inside of all of us that makes us realize that I'm missing something? We live at a moment where by next year, the second greatest cause of disease in the world is mental illness. Because there is an overwhelming ache in people's hearts to be seen, to be known. And the promise of Isaiah hundreds of years before Jesus ever came was to you and I to say, he shall be born of a virgin and they'll call him Emmanuel, God with us. It's not a religion you see on TV. Not a religion where you go and do a certain practice to try and earn our way into God's love. But he wants to be with you. And his being with us is not kind of like, you know, maybe some of our households are, where people are present, but they're not engaged. We call that a husband. He's not like that. God's promise is to be with. The word with means intimately involved with. God's promise is to come up close and personal with us. And God's sustaining power of the unseen presence of God for centuries has made weak people strong. It's made the deathbed a place of triumph. It's brought hope to people in their old age. It's brought courage to people who are desperate. Reconciliation to marriages and families. It's brought freedom to people with addictions. And tonight, just like right now, I would say that most of you would have hunger pains. Hunger pains are a warning that you were designed to eat. Loneliness is a warning that you were designed to have relationship with God. And it's God's heart tonight to be with you, to be close to you, that you wouldn't leave this place with this sense of disconnectedness and hopelessness and meaningless in life. When in 1966, when the Beatles wrote that song, Eleanor Rigby, all the lonely people, where have they all come from? Well, we know where they've come from. They've come from a life without God, disconnected. God wants to connect us tonight. So right now, I'm going to pray, very simple prayer. And I know for many people here tonight, as we have in all services, that there'd be people here that you know that you don't have a relationship with Jesus. You may know about him. You may have gone to church at times, but you can't say tonight that God is with me. There's a gap. And you know there's a gap. And I'm going to pray a simple prayer for all of us tonight. And I want you to pray it with me. And I want you to pray it in your heart. Not with your head, not trying to work it all out because we'll never have all the answers, but with your heart tonight. That maybe tonight you would say, hey, I'm not going to fill that void in my heart with other stuff. I'm tired of trying to find happiness in everything external. It's costly. It's cost you. Maybe tonight God's saying, I want to be with you. That's what Christmas is about. He is Emmanuel. God with us. And so after we pray, out in the foyer, on the left-hand side, there's a table. And on that table, it's real simple. There's a Bible. There's some literature about what it means to have God with us. Very, very simple. But it's important to us as a church that we just don't put on an hour's worth of carols and some great video done by some incredibly talented people. But our whole goal is that more people like myself would leave this place with a sense of I am valued, I'm important to God, so much so that He wants to be with me. So can we pray together? And maybe tonight you'll pray this for the first time from the bottom of your heart. Father, I thank You for every single person here tonight. And I pray in this place, Lord, we recognize that we have got a hole in our heart. We don't like admitting that we're alone. But there are moments in our life that we recognize that's exactly what we are. So, Father, tonight, simply, I pray, would You be with me? For every young person struggling with addiction tonight, would You be with us? For every young lady struggling with identity tonight, would You be with me? For every married couple contemplating separation, would You be with us? For every sick body, would You be with us? For everyone that's overwhelmed with depression and darkness, would You be with us tonight? God, and every single person that's facing another Christmas without loved ones, would You become real to us? So that when we leave this place, and maybe when we put our head on our pillow, maybe when we wake in the morning, that there will be something different because God is with me. And I thank You for it in Jesus' name.
Awesome. Hey, before we wrap up tonight, we do just want to echo just for a little bit longer. If you are someone, maybe you don't feel ready to make a decision tonight to say, I want to follow Jesus, but there is part of you right now that's saying, I have questions. I don't know what the next step is, but I want to know what my personal next step is. And I got two options for you tonight that I want to let you know about. The first one is, after the service, like Pastor Ross was just mentioning, would you come out and see us at the Next Steps area? It's just outside and to the left. There'll be a few team members there. We're basically there to answer any questions we possibly can be. This church doesn't just exist for those that already know Jesus, but wherever you're at in your faith journey, whether it's at the minor point where you don't even really know anything, or you've been following Jesus for years, we are here as a church to help you on your next step. So please come and talk to us after. Alternatively, in the seat pocket in front of you, we have our red cards. And this is basically a point of call for anyone that's brand new with us tonight. Maybe you're a guest and have some questions about what we do or what it looks like on a normal weekend. You can grab this card any point now, just for some of your details. It's not a mailing list. It's not so that we can get your details and send you stuff. It's actually so that we can get someone in contact with you and help you in any way that we possibly can. And then, of course, you grab this card. After the service, we have red spot boxes, which are at the back of this auditorium here and also in the foyer as well. If you can't find the red spot boxes, find someone in an elf costume or someone with a Santa hat on or something. I'm sure they'll be able to point you in the direction of a red spot boxes. You can place that card in there straight after the service, and someone will get in contact with you, answering any questions they possibly can to help you on this journey of following Jesus. Well, that is officially the end of our service tonight, but do want to officially invite you back to next Sunday, okay? It's not just a one-off thing for us. Every Sunday, we're here at 8 a.m., 10 a.m., and 6 p.m. as well. We'll be going all normal services next week, back to normal, continuing on. But we do want to find out what happened to the Joneses in our video, right? We don't just want to leave you, open-ended. So we'll just take a look to the screen, and the guys are going to take us out on one more carol. Merry Christmas.
Christmas Day dawns bright. Joey woke with a start, and she knew she felt different deep down in her heart. The Christmas joy she thought was lost had been found. She leapt out of bed and down the stairs she did bound. And her face shone with joy and her eyes grew wide.
This is the best Christmas ever,
she cried. And that is how Josephine Jones from Down Under discovered that Jesus is the source of all wonder and the greatest gift, not just for Christmas Day, but for each moment she chooses to follow His way. So enjoy this season and remember God's Son. And of course, a Merry Christmas to everyone.